Hello my friends, welcome to another exciting episode in our Photoshop design series. In this video, I'm going to be walking you through the process of creating a social media flyer like this inside of Photoshop. So if you don't mind, get your pieces ready and let's get started. Before I forget, if you've not subscribed, now is the best time to subscribe to my channel so you won't miss anything I'm dropping anytime from now. If you've not gotten the Smart Designer Premium Assets, now is the right time to get yours so you won't miss out on getting the 3D text, the flyer templates, the fonts and the images, the PNG images and everything that is inside of this bundle, right? Without having to say much, let's get started. So the first thing I like to do is go over to file, click on new, and I'm just going to change my size 5 by 5 inches. And up here is where I impute the name of what I want to create, which is a social media flyer. So I'm just going to have social media flyer here, and it's going to be 5 by 5 300 transparent. And when you're done, click on create, and this brings us into the Photoshop interface. So two things you want to make sure of is, first one, you want to make sure, I'll double click here, make sure your foreground color is this color and your background color is this color, so you can use this color code, right? Copy and paste inside. So I'm starting with the background color, so I'm just going to flip it solid color and click OK. So this is what you have, right? So I'm going over to my resource file. The link to the resource file for this particular video is in the description of this video, alongside the link to download the Smart Designer Premium Asset, right? So having said that, coming back to this, what I want to do is I'm going to increase the size like this and click enter when you're done. Select the mask and go over to brush, make sure your cap lock is not on, and gently remove the edges like this. This is what you should do. And what I'm going to do next is convert it to smart objects. So I'm going to click on convert to smart objects, which converts it to a smart object. Go over to filter and I'm going to use blur, Gaussian blur. So for this, you can copy my settings. So the settings I'm going to use for this is 9.8. all right, so make a duplicate copy of the two of them and group them, right? Adjustment, hue and saturation, and create clipping mask, so it's just affecting that image itself. So click on colorize and bump the saturation up to 97, and inside here I'm going to change the blend mode to screen, right? Change the blend mode to screen like this, and I'm going to click on the first one, quickly modifying it, double click on the Gaussian blur, and I'm just going to increase it. That's the only difference I'm going to make here, right, apart from the initial Gaussian blur. So this is what I'm going to do. So what I'm going to do with this is I'm just going to maybe increase it a bit. Yeah, okay, good, but not as the one on top. So I think I'm done with this. So next thing I want to do is let's see, so let me close this up so I don't complicate things. So let me go ahead and bring in the next element I'm going to be using, which is the image of this guy here. So you can get it under, inside of the graphics bundle. So if you have purchased yours, this is where the image that I use for this is. So I'm just going to go and get mine. These are PNG images, different from the images that are inside here. So I'm just going to bring this inside here like this. And of course, I don't want it to interfere with this, so I'm just going to arrange this back. Right click and clipping mask. So this image should be on top of everything currently that you have inside of your Photoshop. So I'm just going to resize this by increasing the size from the edge like this, and then of course bringing it down again when I'm done to the location where I want it to be. Create and click okay, so hold down control and click on the image itself and click on mask to mask out the image itself. Go over to filter, and what you want to select is minimum, right? Under order, you get minimum. So click OK like this, like we've done in previous video, and go over to exposure, right click, and create clipping mask like this. Now what you should do here is reduce the exposure like this, not too much, somewhere around here is good. And adjustment layer, click on solid color. Now I'm going to be working with this color here. So with my eyedropper selected, I'm going to select this color, which is the color of the background as it is currently, right? This light green color like this. So I'm going to change the blend mode to overlay. Click on overlay. And the next thing I'm going to do is right click and create clipping mask like this. Now what I'm going to do next is I'm going to invert it. I'm going to invert the color like this so I can use my brush to paint over. But I'm not going to start with this. I'm going to start with the exposure I created. So what I'm going to do now is very, very simple and easy. I'm going to go back to my brush, B for brush, and I'm just going to reveal the areas that I want light to hit. Like this, on this part. So, the areas that I want my light to hit is actually the natural source of light that was on him before. So it's not as if I'm trying to create something new out of anything. So I'm going to reduce the flow here because I want to get delicate. So click on this and drop the flow like this. And I'm just going to reveal light here, these areas like this. And we're good to go. So over here, I'm just going to click on this and reveal the light also. Swap that the white color because you're working on the black mask. Right, so I'm just going to reveal things here. Reveal, reveal. Also reveal here. I'm just going to go on and on and on with this. Right, if you make any mistake, you feel you are not doing it well, please do not forget that Ctrl Z is not your enemy. So Ctrl Z and go back to undo and till you get the right thing done. Right, so I'm just going to have it on these areas like this, and yes, we're good to go. Even on the head region here where I want it to be pronounced, I'm going to make it more pronounced. Okay, so at this point we are good to go. So what I'm going to do next is go over to adjustment layer, and this time what I want to do is select photo filter. Now this part is very vital also. Clip it, and immediately you clip it, click on the color here, and what you want to do is change it to that green that we used earlier on, which is this. Then click OK. You can see how it is before and after, right? So that's why it's called photo filter. Most times it's good to use these filters in your projects to make work easy and fast, right? So I'm just going to reduce this just a bit so it's not too much, because I can sense that it's a bit too much. Create a hue and saturation adjustment layer just in this position here. Is it hue and saturation? Okay, so yes, hue and saturation. And what you want to do is click on that and come and sample a color here, right? So what you want to do is change the position of the hue. You can see how I moved this from blue to this light green that it's wearing, and I also reduce the lightness also, right? So with this one, I'm just going to hue and saturation, create a new layer above that, swap this, and I'm just going to use my brush, and I'm going to reduce the opacity like this, change the blend mode to screen, and create another layer again above this, and I'm just going to apply the same thing with my brush selected. I'm just going to create some light effect here along this line here. Good. So I'm going to create brightness and contrast. So I'm just going to play with my contrast alone this time around, increase my saturation that I've created before, and what else do I need to do again? Okay, so at this point I think this is good. I'm going to reduce the overlay like this, and we are good to go. Okay, so I'm just going to bring in the text. I already typed this just to save us some time. I'm just going to drag and drop inside, click enter, And when I'm done with this, I can see that it's interfering with what I have just above. But that's not a problem. Let me just quickly type this, and I'm just going to change the direction. So Ctrl T to actually transform this. When you're done, click Enter. Ctrl J to duplicate this. And what you want to do is double click, and this should be more wings. So I'm just going to select this one, move it downwards, select two of them, Ctrl T, and make it smaller like this. Bring this down just this way, and voila, we're good to go. So for this one, I'm just going to change a couple of things. For this one, I'm just going to make it white like this. Click OK. And then also for the save bits, double click, but I'm just going to make only the save white. So click on the color and make it white like this. And there you go, save bits, more wings. Right? Drag this one up, fix this one back, right click, and clipping mask. Okay, so there you have it. Almost done. So I'm going to select all of these, move them downwards. Just a bit, not too much, and clicking on the topmost layer, which is the more wings, I'm going to go over and bring in my last but not the least element, which is this guy here, which is the logo. So I'm basically dragging and dropping inside. That's all I'm doing. I'm not doing too much. So drag and position this well here. You might want to make this smaller. Click Enter when you're done. Right click and go over to the blending option. And what you should do is select color overlay and make sure your color is white, right? Easy peasy, right? I guess so. So now I'm just going to put this way. And what I'm going to do next is click on this, create a new layer, and what I'm going to do is revert the foreground color to the darker color, and with my brush selected, I'm just going to paint this way. Make sure you are painting the way I am actually doing mine, right? So to get the same result, very, very important. Please, if you don't understand any part, feel free to rewind your video and take your time to watch, pause, play, and implement. That's the best way to learn, please. All right, so with this selected, I want to increase the visibility. So how do I do this? I'm just going to bring this down, and that other one stays up. I just switched positions. So I think I like the way it is right now. I like that light effect and that swirl effect I have going on behind. Good to go, right? So just a couple of things I want to do to balance this up. I'm going to increase the density of the image like this, or reduce it. So I'm going to increase it instead, not reduce it, please. So this is how it is. I have this green effect going on all around it. So I'm just going to select the image. I should have done that this from the beginning of the tutorial, but I'm going to do this now. So I'm just going to make the image pop, increase texture, increase the haze, and also reduce the highlights and increase the shadow like this. And when you're done, you click OK. So this is what you have as the final result for the image. You can go on and on and on trying to adjust these things, but then I'll just leave mine this way, and I can control my filter here, or I can control it from the density. So whichever way you tend to want to put it or see it like is perfect. So I can reduce the density like this, and we're good to go. All right guys, if you've liked this tutorial, make sure you don't forget to first give it a thumbs up, If you've not subscribed, push the subscribe button. And I'll see you in next video just above.